Everyone, this is Namrita, and today we are going to learn how to make methods in Spring async. So when we say we are going to make methods in Spring async, what do we mean by that? Right, so async means when we trigger a method, and after triggering that method, we don't have to wait for that method to complete. Let's suppose we have multiple email shooting that we have to do. We are going to send multiple emails to certain people. Like, let's suppose that we have 100 people we have to send emails to. So sending out emails to 100 users is going to take a huge amount of time. So to reduce that time, we cannot rely upon the email server, right? But we can do one thing. We can send those 100 email addresses to the service, and we can move ahead of that execution. So in that way, our program creates two threads. In the main thread, our program will get executed, and in the other thread, which is initialized, that other thread will keep on executing the email shooting of those 100 users. So in that way, the main thread will not wait for that email shooting program to complete. So in that way, if we see our APIs in the Spring, then APIs need to give a fast response, right? So we cannot wait for such heavy processes to get completed. So in that way, async methods are useful. So let's suppose I have a pretty big procedure which takes around 10 minutes to get complete. So it creates, let's suppose, lakhs of records, but for that I'm doing an API call. On that API call, that procedure is dependent upon. So whatever I do is I will create that method which calls the procedure as async, and my API will trigger that method and leaves the controller. So in that way, the async methods of Spring are useful. So this was our two use cases in which async methods are useful. So let's see how we can create a async methods. Right, so for starter, we are going to use a Spring initializer to create our sample project. So in that, I am keeping the artifact name as async, nothing special about creating the project, a simple web project, okay? So I have already downloaded it and imported in my Eclipse. Here you can see. So here is my Spring application. I have only three files over here: async application, async controller, and async service. Okay. So async application, you'll see first, it is just simple void main class, which will start my Spring Boot application. Then async controller has my service for book. This service gives me the details of the book. Here is the service which I want it to be async. So let's see, without making this method as async, how does it works? Okay, I'm going to start my server. Yes, so the server is getting started. Yeah, it is started now. Let me clear the logs. Okay, so I have this API, books API. Okay, so here I am calling this API. Okay, so let's see what happens. I am putting it as send. I am clicking on send. Here it is getting called. It's saying inside get controller. It is saying before service call, right? So you can see the time also. It is at 13 seconds, then 18, after 5 seconds, after 5 seconds. So in this service you can see, so I'm putting it as 5 seconds delay. So here you can see that my method was started on 5:50:13. Then the method, this line got executed at after 5 seconds, that is 5:50:23. Then the next call, as I have put it as a loop of 5 method calls, so it got called 5 times and all were after 5 seconds. Okay, so this was this, and so before service call time was logged as 5:50:13, and after service call the time was logged as 5:50:38. Okay, now let's see in the this postman also, how much time did it take? It took almost 25 seconds to complete this method. Okay, so this was the execution when our method is not async. Now let's make it as async, and then we'll see how much time does it take. Okay, so how do we make a method as async? So here we need to have two annotations, and that much only can make our method as async. So first annotation I'll talk about is enable async, and the other annotation is async, right? So this enable async is the basic annotation which will enable our application to provide async capability. Okay, and the async annotation annotates that the which particular method are we going to make async. Okay, so here in this method, so let's suppose I want to make this method as async. So for making my application capable of doing an async method, I have to put a enable async method, enable async annotation over here. Then I have to put async annotation over the method on which I want to create as async. Okay, here it is. Okay, so this should work, and this is it. There is nothing much we need to do to make any method async. These two annotations are completely sufficient to make our method as async. Okay, so here I will start my server again. Yes, now my server is started. Okay, now I will execute this API again. Okay, so as you can see that the before and service call were called, before and service statement were executed on the similar time like in a second only it was done, like 57 and 58, okay. But all the other book service were created as a separate child threads, and those all the threads which were created were executed on 5:55:03. So exactly after 5 seconds. Okay, so now you need to consider one more thing over here, that in this I was calling this thread service method 5 times, so there were 5 child threads which were created. Okay, so that is why these 5 threads executed at the same time. And now if we look at our API call, so our API call didn't even took a single second. It was completed in milliseconds because it didn't wait for this method to get over. So these all child threads were initialized, and the main thread started executing the next step of it. Okay, so this was the main things regarding async and async methods. There are various scenarios, two of which I have mentioned. There can be endless scenarios in which async is used, mainly in integration processes, when we are working with different servers and a huge time consuming processes. So this is the key for faster services, and this was it. So let me know if you have any doubts or you want anything else on async. I would be creating it. Thank you for today. Thank you so much.